Mitchell Drive for 3/4 mile. Exit the traffic circle. In a 1/4 mile, your destination will be on the left. Is on the left.
Of 1980, there were many problems facing our nation. The tragic neglect of our military establishment, an ailing economy, the continuing expansion of communism abroad. But to me, none was more serious than the fact America had lost faith in itself.
Stations are closed, the phone lines are jammed.
Every day there's something rising prices.
It's time to recognize that we've come to a turning point. We're threatened with an economic calamity of tremendous proportions. And the old business as usual treatment can't save us.
It's a failure of our leaders to establish rational goals and give our people something to order their lives.
Taken shots at President Reagan.
From the outset, the president's unfailing sense of humor conceals the life-threatening danger he is in.
The next thing I knew, I was lying face up on a gurney, and my brand new suit was being cut off of me. I looked up and saw Nancy looking down at me. And I said, I forgot to duck.
The first one to bring it into the Oval Office was John F. Kennedy.
Oh, okay.
Remember the famous picture? I don't know if you knew it. John Crowley on there. Okay, he figured it out that panel can be removed.
There you go.
And because that panel was not part of the original. It was requested by Franklin Delano Roosevelt because he didn't like people to see his braces. But he passed away before it was installed, you know.
Interesting.
Now, in the bottom also, it had been raised 1.5 to 2 inches for President Reagan because he couldn't sit properly under the desk. That's another change to the desk.
What do you say about someone who makes sacrifices so that your life will be easier and more successful? Nancy, let me say thank you for all you do. Thank you for your life. Thank you for just being you.
They both battled each other. The missing part, he was good at what she was and she was good at what he wasn't. And they just completed each other.
Okay. There is a snack to play with.
good enough.
So that's when you want to
just... And fellow Americans, I have recently been told that I am not the millions of Americans.
Cafe.
Okay, we'll go.
Yeah, that can help with the...
One evening, I noticed her name, my name, in the list of communist sympathizers in Hollywood.
Nancy was desperate to clear her name, and she was told that Ronald Reagan, president of the Screen Actors Guild, might be able to help.
If ever God gave me evidence that he had a plan for me, it was the night he brought Nancy into my life.
I don't know if it was exactly love at first sight, but it was pretty close. We had dinner together the next night, and the night after that, and the one after that.
Nancy likes to say, you know, her life began when she...
And as he traveled around the country to vote, he couldn't wait to get back to her.
How come it keeps getting harder to say goodbye? You'd think I'd be used to it, but I'm not. Maybe that job in Washington wouldn't be so bad. You'd be right upstairs.
I threw myself into the various first lady roles, spokeswoman, manager, hostess.
All through their marriage, her ability to orchestrate social events really helped Reagan not only become president, but to be an effective president.
She really grew in that office over time and really did take that spotlight. And instead of having it just pouring light into her face, she turns it around, bringing that spotlight.
So you're a special person who's turned the fight against drug abuse into a national crusade. She mobilized the American people.
Hello.
All right, kid. I'll see you in a little while.
Yeah.
Keep on going. Every good chance we get. Thank you.
they'd be the one around.
Industrial design genius, Raymond Loewy. He worked out his concept sketches for hours on the floor of the Oval Office using colored paper and crayons.
Very peculiar about it is that the rank would tend to fade away. There was an informality about the plane that was just something I cherish in retrospect.
My last flight, they gave me a champagne party with a little cake and everything, and he wanted me to have a glass of champagne. I told him, I said, well, Mr. President, you know, I'm still officially on duty, and that's against Air Force regulations. So, just like that, he said,
I'm very excited about it. We're so happy.
Snapshots is fine, but
okay.
No flash or no videos.
All right. Oh, thank you. No videos? Okay. Yeah,
work.
Yes.
Hello.
Welcome to Marine One. We take photos right before you go in. There's an obligation to purchase them. You can see them at the counter.
Always on the go.
Yeah. I don't know. He's got so many helpers, it's crazy. But he'll be at my house this week, I hope. I've been good.
I hope so.
Now, I want an old car to restore.
Wow. How's that?
Okay. I have one that has a 1926 Ford.
Oh my gosh.
And a 1928. Yeah, I got pictures of them.
I'm jealous. Oh my.
I'm jealous
too. That's
so
much fun.
Hey, well, I used to race cars for Galpin Ford.
Really?
Slalom race.
Yeah.
The GT350, GT500.
Okay.
Shelby Cobras. They let me use it every weekend, moving around, put me in their calendar.
Hello.
Sir, is it all right? We'll take a picture of them.
Or there's many.
So I get them sit down.
Yeah. Want to be in between us?
Yeah.
There we go.
All right. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. For the ball of Christmas spirit.
Get a couple here and just be sure. All right.
Thank you very much, sir. Have a good one.
That way you can prove that you are not Santa Claus.
this is the second half of the tour.
Thank you.
Strengthened our country's position as a force for peace and progress in the world.
He was a tough, hard bargainer. He was a Russian patriot who loved his country. But there was a chemistry that kept our conversations on a man-to-man basis without hate or hostility.
On December 8, 1987,
The two leaders also had their differences and agreed to destroy an entire class of nuclear weapons.
It is in the name of eternal humanity that we have today performed our momentous deed.
The following spring, I went to Moscow, where President Gorbachev and I signed the formal ratification papers, putting the INF agreement into force.
We came to respect each other, probably even like each other. They were very different kinds of people. Nevertheless, they talked, they bargained, they achieved things.
Once you begin a great movement, there's no telling where it is.
So it evolved into what's called Camp David, so Eisenhower renamed it Shangri-La, originally Camp David, David Eisenhower. And that cabin he's named after a type of tree. It's about a, I guess, it was probably a half hour, probably not a full time. Good stuff about an hour.
Well, this is a big
mourns the passing of a president tonight. Ronald Reagan, surrounded by his family, died at his home in California today after a long and difficult battle.
With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother, Ronald Reagan. Let's pray with confidence to God, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints.
Don't let anyone tell you that America's best days are behind her. That the American spirit has been vanquished. We seem to try too often in our lives to stop believing in it now.
The history says these prevailing years, the American Revolution was beaten. And freedom in the new proof of America reached for the yes. As we continue our journey, we close and pray to our voice.
Damn it.
What, you want to go to Fort Lauderdale?